All right, guys, so in this video, we're going to be doing another PvE progression. This one is probably going to be the last PvE progression I'm going to do for a while, and then I'm going to go back to doing PvP progressions. But since the Diluvian mechanism is, you know, still fucking, like, it's basically just, like, the most interesting thing in Deepwoken to me at this point, especially, like, you know, because the fact that wave 50 gives you, like, the best loot in the entire game. So, yeah, the build that I've cooked up for this video is basically going to be the same one that I used in the soloing the Diluvian event video. Because a lot of people are asking me to, you know, leak the build for that. So yeah, I'm going to be remaking that. But instead of going a Sacred Field build, which is why I went last time, this is going to be a full DPS build. It's going to be doing 1,800 damage per swing, which is fucking insane, by the way. It's just going to be a pure DPS build. It's still going to have brick walls, so it's going to be really good. Like, obviously, you won't be able to solo this, bro. I'm pretty sure no build in the entire game can solo this. But yeah, it's going to be very, very good. It's M1 orientated, but you can also use Munches or, like, Onslaught, Exhaust and Strike. They're all very, very good. Onslaught's very, very nice for crowd control. But yeah, it's basically just going to be a massive DPS build with M1 orientated. And you need Astral to make this build. I would only recommend making this build if you have Astral. All right, cool. So pre-shine, we're going to be going 100 willpower and 100 fortitude. And also force intelligence. This is for, you don't need all their gods, but you might as well just grab it. This is for overflowing dam, all their gods, brick wall, reinforced armor, piercing will. You can get shared misery as well if you want. You don't really need to, but it's nice if you get ganked in the depths. You can just pop heritage future and make their fucking their eyes start clawing out, bro. And like, you can just destroy them. You're gonna be doing so much M1 damage. I looked it up on the Deepwoken build maker. 1.8k damage per swing if you activate auto scream, which is like absolutely insane. Off the shrine, we're gonna be getting 25 agility, 30 strength, and then the rest we're going to be bumping into heavy weapon. We're going to be left off with 99 heavy weapon on the dot. Well, it depends what race you use, but if you use any race that has like stats in these, nothing in charisma, it should be 99 heavy weapon every single time. And then for the belt, obviously we're going to be going crazy slots instead of sacred field on this build, and I'm going to try and get corrupt crazy slots. You don't need corrupt crazy slots, but I really want to get corrupt crazy slots just so that we can get like the insanity downside. I really want to get the insanity downside because we're going to be running illusion mind, obviously. All right, cool, let's start the progression. I already gave myself some, like, I fucking saw a meteor event and I decided to loot all the chests, okay, before I came over here. So I basically have a bunch of DVM gear on me right now, and I'm also, okay, wait, hold up. hold up. Hold up. Okay, we're chilling, bro. Yo. Okay, wait, hold up. Chill. Dodge. Wait. Okay. Oh, bro. The way I was... Okay. And then we have a 2-star damage Balex with Providence Force. Okay, that was way too close for comfort. I can't lie, bro. I shouldn't have been talking while doing that. Holy crap. All right, cool. They did change a few things about the trial since the Diluvian mechanism only solo progression video. They made it so wave 13, if you guys watched that video, wave 13 was 2 corrupt owls and 2 corrupt snow golems, bro. But I managed to get Archimedes to change it to 2 normal sand golems. So yeah, it's actually going to be doable now as a lower level. Unlike it was impossible before, which is like actually crazy. And we killed that so fast, bro. The last time we did this progression, that took me like probably 6 to 7 minutes to kill that alone, which is actually crazy. But yeah, I'm gonna get to wave 5 and then I'm going to go and pull my stat points in. Actually, after I kill this, I'm going to go and pull my stat points and I'm going to just, like, you know, crouch in the corner over there. All right, guys, another thing that I forgot to mention is we're going to be trying to get the wave 50 armor on this build. What the wave 50 armor does, I forgot what it's called. I think it's called the Sultorian something. But what it does, it has a talent on it where if you lose 25% of your HP in the space of 3 seconds, you gain a massive damage boost. I think it's like 25% damage boost. You also gain a massive defense boost. And you also cannot be knocked for 10 seconds. Correct me if I'm wrong, but last time I saw it, it said you cannot be knocked for 10 seconds, which basically just makes us immortal for 10 seconds. And we're going to be dealing like probably 2.3k damage per M1. So in those 10 seconds, we're like Hikari, bro. In those 10 seconds, we're effectively immortal, bro. We're literally immortal. And we're going to keep on getting health packs on health packs. So we're basically, we're going to be unkillable, bro. This is just going to be the best DPS build in the entire game if we have that armor. All right, cool. We just beat wave 5. I didn't get anything good, unfortunately, bro. Yesterday when I was farming my friends, I got an idol of Yun Shu from one of these chests. I'm not even kidding. So if you're a lucky person, bro, these chests can be hella good. But yeah, let me see if I can level up again. The plan is, I'm going to keep on doing this over and over again until I get, you know, 100 willpower. And then once I've got 100 willpower and 40 intelligence, I'm going to just leave the depths, go to my boy Brutus, and just spam fortune, because I'm definitely going to have enough EXP to get all the way from 0 to 100 fortune to 100%, bro. I did it yesterday. You have more than enough EXP to do that. So yeah, I'm going to see if I can level up real quick. All right, nice. We're power 3 already. Disbelief, loot skipper. I don't know what oath I'm going to get on this. I think I am going to get blindsteer on this. So yeah, I'm going to get all the blindsteer talents, because I definitely do want to get that 10% monster armor. That's going to be very helpful as well. Breathing exercise. Yep. Let me get that. Savior, old habits die hard. I'm gonna get fish, man. I want to get all the red talents out of the way, just so you know I don't miss any of the important ones, and then another point of vitality. All right, cool, perfect. I'm not gonna do wave six to ten, because wave six to ten is just all angels and corrupted mud skipper knights. So yeah, I'm not doing that. It takes way too long. Wave one to five is just the best thing to do. I'm not even kidding. So yeah, don't even bother doing the angels. I'm not joking. Like, it takes way too long. All right, nice. I can't lie, I skipped a good 3 levels. But yeah, we're power 6 now. It's been going hella fast, bro. I would definitely recommend getting Provenance Force Battle Axe. It just makes the whole thing like 10 times faster. I'll get a new replacement to see why the hell not. I'll just reroll it later if I'm missing a rare. Mantra permanence, Eureka. Okay, I don't need that either, but I'll get that as well. It's nice just having spare rares that you don't need, just in case you ever want to reroll rares for like something else that you need, like lose your mind or something like that. Because sometimes I'll be missing talents and I have no rares to pick from because I burn like Eureka and stuff like that. But like, bro, just pick them so you can reroll them later on. I'm telling you now, bro. There's no harm in having talents that you don't need. Like, bro, like you can always reroll them later, bro. I'm telling you now. All right, nice. And not even half an hour. Like, I've probably only been progressing for 20 minutes. I'm not even kidding, because I was like recording my intro and everything like that for a good 10 minutes. Yeah, it's only been like 20 minutes and we're already power 7. 7 triple power 14 talents, bro. This is so fun. I'll definitely recommend using Providence Spawns, because without Providence Spawns, it would take you like 2 times, 3 times longer. I'm not even kidding. All right, I'm going to get Triathlete. Let me pirate that last time. Okay. Defiance. Yeah, I'm going to get Defiance. Defiance is very nice. And then another point into Vitality. All right, cool. All right, I'm going to just keep on progressing. Okay, yo. All right, I need to stop talking. All right, yeah, the waves are getting extremely fast now. It's only taking me like 3 to 4 minutes to do from wave 1 to 5. Not even that, like 3 minutes, yeah. But yeah, as soon as I get to 100 willpower, I'm going to immediately leave the depths and then go to Brutus at full merit just so I can get 100 fortitude in like 2 seconds. I do have Vow of Thorns on and Deep Champions, so my child's going to probably be like a corrupt, what's it called? A corrupt Lightning Skibbo and a corrupt King Thresh, or even a corrupt Bone Keeper if I'm unlucky. But I do have Providence Thorns and Ishin's Ring, so I'm like pretty confident in myself. I might take off the Ishin's Ring actually, because I feel like the grab would actually one-shot me with the Bone Keeper. So yeah, I need to be careful of that. But yeah, I'm pretty confident with doing it, I can't lie. Like, another reason that I wanted to make this build as well, and like, I know a lot of people are probably gonna say in the comments, oh, but mantras are meta, like scribbers can't do it, scribbers can't vent mantras in this anymore. Like, okay, that's a good point, I can't lie, but there are some waves that are extremely cancer because you can't use any mantras. That's one of the reasons why I wanted to make this build. The other reason is that when I was doing it with people that have mantra builds, like mantra PvE builds, bro, I was getting hit by my teammates more than I was getting hit by the enemies, bro. So if everyone uses like a massive M1 DPS build and we all have sacred field like this, bro, it's gonna be so easy. I'm telling you now, all you need is like 3 people with sacred field. So just so you can, you know, like as soon as one person's sacred field comes with cooldown, you just instantly activate it. I'm not even kidding. If you just have 3 people with sacred field, it is the most easy thing in the entire world to get to wave 50. I'm not even kidding. 3 people with sacred field that have, you know, at least 40% DVM, and you'll do it every time. I'm not even kidding. You just need coordination, being a VC, etc., etc. Like, it's gonna be so easy. I'm not even kidding. All right, nice. We got power 8. I got piercing will. Before I escape the depths, so once I have 100 willpower, I do, since we're right next to Widow anyways, I do want to get tier 1 insanity, or tier 2 insanity even, before I escape. Just so I don't forget to do it later. And I also need to remember to get Heritage Sutra as well, because on the last build that I made, I accidentally forgot to get Heritage Sutra pre-shrine. So that build is a major L, bro. But I'm definitely not going to forget to get it this time. All right, nice. We got 100 willpower on the door, which is perfect. So yeah, I'm going to quickly go to Widow and get tier 2 insanity before I leave the depths. Also, for anybody that does want to go Silent Hunt on this instead of Blindseer, you can, but you're going to be left off with only 70 heavy weapon in the end. I did test it, and it only does like 2 more M1 damage. I'm not even kidding. Like, well, with all the damage modifiers, you're going to be doing like 10 to 15 more M1 damage. It's just not worth it, bro. I'm telling you now. And you're going to be missing out on the 10% monster armor from Tankle Circles here. In all honesty, I wouldn't recommend it. You can if you want, but I wouldn't recommend it. All right, nice. We are shivering insanity now, so I'm gonna escape the depths. Hopefully we don't have to fight a corrupt Bone Keeper, but there's like a 70% chance that we will. So yeah, I'm not gonna use my Ishin's Ring, because I would like to survive one of this grab moves. If you guys don't know already, the grab move will one shot you if you have an Ishin's Ring on. So yeah, I would like to survive at least one of those. You can't survive two. That's the armor that I want as well. But yeah, you can't survive two, but I will be able to survive one. And usually I only make one mistake when fighting them. If I'm unlucky. So yeah, I'd rather just be safe than sorry, to be honest. What's the trial gonna be, bro? Okay, and of course it's a Corrupt the Bone Keeper. That's nice. All right, let me parry that. All right, cool. I'm gonna just cut this because it's gonna take a very long time to kill this guy. All right, cool. I can't lie. I've been fighting him for like a good 2 minutes now. I'm still five barring him. I haven't got hit by a single move, luckily, bro. But I'm not gonna lie, Bone Keepers are very, very easy to kill. It's just sometimes I accidentally roll cancel the grab, and roll canceling mobs doesn't really work out too well. I can't lie. So that's the only time I usually get hit by him. But yeah, we should be chilling. Plus, I have an investment point left to put into a stat just in case I do, you know, somehow get to one shot. But yeah, now we should be chilling. And then I'm probably gonna have to fight. It's either gonna be a king, a corrupted king Gusher, a corrupted bone keeper again, or a corrupted lightning skibbles. Yeah, hopefully it's you know what? I kind of want to fight the corrupt lightning skibble the most, to be honest, because it's gonna be very, very easy with the providence spawns better. Like, all right, nice, we killed it, and okay, it's another another corrupt. Okay, nice. All right, I'm gonna just cut the next 3 minutes out, bro. Also, another reason why I wanted to make this build as well, like an M1 build of Astral, is because, bro, the amount of shadow NPCs that there are as well, like not NPCs, sorry, shadow creatures, like mobs, in the later waves, like you'll have like 3 corrupt owls that all have shadow variants on you, bro. You can't use any mantras in that situation, bro. I'm telling you, you can't. So there's just no point. So yeah, that's another reason why I really wanted to make an M1 orientated PvE build again as well, because I'm not gonna lie, I just prefer it in every way. I prefer it in every way. The only situation I prefer mantra PvE builds in is layer 2, obviously, so I can one cycle chase or I'm one cycle Aetheron with ease. But in the hell mode and the new Diluvian event, bro, definitely M1 builds, bro. Definitely M1 builds. All right, nice. You powered up. I'm going to get Return to the Dark Ages. I might get that as well because it just gives you posture, I guess. I'll get that. Yeah, I'll get that. Well, I don't know. I also kind of want to get Warriors of Spy as well. We do have Overflowing. Yeah, we have everything that we can get right now. All I need to do now is just get all the Bastion talents and Reinforced Armor and Brick Wall. Those are literally the only things that we need now. And then we can finally Shine of Water. Also, Heritage Sutra. Don't forget. I need to not forget to get Heritage Sutra, bro, because I'll actually ruin the entire build. All right, nice. We have all of the stats that we need to Shrine of Order now, but I am missing Heritage Sutra, which I can go and get now. And I'm also missing Brick Wall. So I'm going to try and get Brick Wall, you know, because I'm already at full merit, just by rolling a talent, because I don't really want to get the extra floor by Shrine of Blasphemying. Here's all our talents so far. Yeah, we did get Reinforced Armor as well. We also got Unfazed. We have Underdog, Giant Slayer. We've literally got everything we could possibly need. Look how many flipping rares we have, bro. That's actually crazy. So yeah, all I need now is Brick Wall. And the thing I have to say to Mystic is I seek the qualities of human architecture. So yeah, I'm going to say that. I'm broke. My bad. I forgot. All right, nice. We have some money now. I also do need to look through my talents again and see if there's any talents that I don't need. There probably is, because I do need to reroll a comment for that. I see the qualities of human architecture. All right, perfect. Let me check through my talents real quick. There has to be at least one comment that I don't need. Triathlete, you some? Yeah, okay, perfect. Triathlete, I'm gonna reroll that. All right, nice. Fingers crossed we get Brick Wall first try. And we did. All right, perfect. We've literally got everything we could possibly need. Conquer Your Fears, we can get off the shrine as well for blind. So that's perfect. So yeah, I'm gonna go back down to the depths now. And then we are power 15 on the door as well, which is perfect. So yeah, we can go and get ourselves heritage. We don't even need to ask someone to send us down. All right, let's go and get Heritage Sutra real quick. And then we can finally Shrine of Order. This is probably the most perfect build I've ever made in my entire life. Like, I'm not even kidding. I've never made a PvE build where I haven't had to Shrine of Blasphemy, bro. And this is the first PvE build I've never had to Shrine of Blasphemy on. All right, nice. We are completely ready to Shrine of Order. We have 1 point put into everything that we need. So yeah, let's go and Shrine of Order real quick. Hopefully I don't get too bad of a floor. The floor that I want the most is Manic. So I'm gonna, if I don't get Manic, I'm gonna keep on rerolling or Shrine of Blasphemy to get it. But yeah, let's Shrine of Order real quick. Strength, heavy weapon, agility, perfect. And yeah, we got Hemophilia. All right, Hemophilia is really bad. So yeah, I'm gonna try and get Manic when the build's max. I don't really care too much about it now. So yeah, let's see if we can get 25 agility just so that we can get Speed Demon and Spine Cutter. All right, perfect. And then we need to get 30 strength as well. So yeah, I'm gonna go and kill a few more mobs. I'm probably gonna go and do the Diluvian mechanism. I mean, I'm probably not gonna do the Diluvian mechanism anymore, because it's gonna put me at wave 6 now, like automatically. So I'm gonna have to fight the humanoid shits, and they give like no EXP and they take 10 times longer than from wave 1 to 5. So yeah, I'm not doing that shit. All right, nice. We powered up again, power 16. Nullifying character safety dance. I'm gonna get nullifying character, why the hell not, just in case they ever have an elemental effect on them from someone else. Just makes you do more damage. Day swinging opponent, sure, I'll get that as well. Whispers from the Deep, Fortune Mobility Mantra. I don't really know which one of these I'm gonna get. I can't lie. I might get Shoulder Bash actually, because I can get that shit to level 4. Yeah, I'm gonna get Shoulder Bash. Why the hell not? All right, nice. I just killed the Widow and leveled up. And we got Speed Demon, but I'm still missing Spine Cutter and Lugia Mind, which is kind of annoying. This progression is going to be so much faster once I get Lugia Mind. I'm not even kidding. Like, it's going to be like 2.5 times faster, I'm pretty sure. That's how much more damage you do. So hopefully we get that soon. If not, I'm going to be pretty mad. Also, if you guys do want to make this build, but you do not have Astral, what I'd recommend that would also be almost equally as good, in my opinion, is get Ignition Deep Delver as your armor and then get Providence Thorns, because Providence Thorns with Ignition Deep Delver is actually so good, because you can parry almost everything in the trial and you're just going to be doing 500 damage per parry, or more than that actually, because you're going to have Chain of Perfection as well. You're just going to be doing so much damage per parry. It's so good. I just had a genius idea. Okay, so I looked at the wiki and it said it has a 1 minute cooldown on the thing where you know, you can't get knocked for 10 seconds, you do like 25% more damage. What I thought is, why not just use Ishin's Ring, bro? Because if I'm already like not getting knocked for 10 seconds, I might as well have an extra fucking 1.2 times more damage on top of the damage buff that the thing already gives me. So I'm probably going to be dealing like 3,000 damage in M1 to the mobs. And by the time the 10 seconds over, wave 50 will already be done. Like, I would have already killed everything with everybody else. Bro, I feel like this build actually might be crazy. Hold up. All right, nice. We powered up again. We're power 18 now. Risky moves. I don't know if I want to get risky moves or not. I want to get uproar for now, actually, because uproar is hella good for PvE. Fast blade, ether blade, conquer phase, running impact. I'm gonna get charge return. That's good as well. Cause, bro, a lot of the mobs have attunements in there, so that's gonna be hella good actually. I'm gonna get heavy hitter as well. That's very helpful too. And then whisper from the deep, gaze, rapid punches, strong left, agility, combat. That's revenge. You know what? Fuck it. I will get revenge actually. I feel like revenge might actually work actually. I don't know why, but I have a strong feeling revenge could actually be nice in this world. Like, imagine that, like, I'm this side of the arena. I have like 20 mobs on me. I just revenge through all of them, and then I'm out of the clear, bro. I'm in the clear. I mean. All right, nice. I just rerolled two talents. I rerolled the Chronostasis and Loot Skipper, and I got Spine Cutter and Lugia Mind. So we've got every single talent that we need now. The build's pretty much maxed. All I need now is my armor, which I'm probably going to use Black Dive for now, or Ignition Deep Devil, but I can't really be asked to farm bounders for that shit. I can't, like, it takes so long. And I need to get a Worn Cog too, bro. That shit is just so long, man. And then I also need to get my Crazy Sword. So yeah, I'm probably gonna have to do layer 2 runs anyways, but I heard that the machine actually gives a bunch of bell procs, so we might not even have to do layer 2 runs. I can't lie. We'll see. All right, now, so we have 75 heavy weapon now. I'm gonna go and do a layer 2 run so I can uncap my heavy weapon. I'm gonna go and equip my Astral Evan Spear Hand Axe as well, so we can kill that shit way more faster. I'm gonna just do one full layer 2 run. Like, I don't need to do a full layer 2 run. I just need to kill Chase to uncap it, but I'm gonna do Ether one as well, just so I can get as many medallions as possible, so I never have to do layer 2 again. Ever again on this build. So yeah, let me quickly equip the Astral Axe, bro. This shit looks drippy as fuck, bro. I actually love the look of this so much. It doesn't look as good as the Evan Spear, in my opinion, but it still looks drippy as hell. All right, cool. Let me go into layer 2 one real quick. All right, nice. I got a Bounder Claw, which is like fucking extremely rare. I got a Bounder Claw. So yeah, I'm definitely going to try and make the Ignition Deep Delver now. I'm going to go and kill as many of the Ice Guys in Floor 2 just so I can get a Frozen Membrane as well. And then I'm pretty sure I spawned at Songseeker as well, so I can just sail over to Miner's Landing is also, yeah, it's not going to be too big of a deal. And I have the blue gem too, I'm pretty sure. Where's my blue gem at? Here it is. Yeah, I have my blue gem. So yeah, we can already craft it pretty much. I just need to grab all the other shits. The Bounder Claw is definitely the hardest thing to get out of all of it, bro. That shit is just so, I don't know why, but Bounder's Core is just the rarest thing in the entire game. All right, cool. We killed Chase. So I don't even take too long, to be honest. I need to, like, 6 cycles of me to kill him, which isn't too bad, to be honest. All right, we got 26. Okay, that's actually not too bad. 26 HP. I'll take that. I'll put it on a different build. We didn't get any high DVM rings either. I can't lie, that was kind of an L chest, bro. I can't lie, that was kind of an L chest. All right, I'm gonna go down into floor 2 now. Hopefully, oh yeah, we did get an auto manifestation as well. All right, cool. So yeah, immediately after this, I'm gonna go to the overworld, get the Worn Cog, kill Kaido, come back down, get auto scream. That's the only time that we're missing pretty much now, and time to go obviously as well. And then we're pretty much max after you go out armor there. We're literally max. All we need now is bell. You know what? I'm gonna try and kill the guys here, bro. I never usually do this, but fuck it, bro. This is how I'm gonna try it, bro. Okay, wait. Is it just him? I thought it spawned more. Oh, it does spawn more. It does spawn more. Okay, I need to kill this guy, bro. Oh, bro, we do so much damage, bro. This is light work, bro. Parry. Dodge. Okay, wait, hold on. Okay, yeah, we're chilling. Okay, yo, I'm gonna go Frozen Membrane. Let's fucking go. Alright, cool, perfect. Alright, yo, can this... Alright, yo, the barrier's going. Alright, nice. Bro, and we killed them that fast without crazy slots as well, bro. Like, we can already stat check them. I don't even have my armor maxed out yet. I'm like, I'm missing rings, and I'm also missing a cape that with DVM on it as well. So we can get like another 20% DVM. On top of that, we're also missing auto scream and crazy slots, bro. If we had all of that, bro, we would be able to kill them in like 4 M1s. I'm not even kidding, bro. This build is actually gonna be insane. All right, cool. I can't lie. We crashed, bro. My fucking game crashed. But luckily, I had some medallion spare on a different slot. So I decided to, buy some dye packets and pack them. So we've got purple eyes now and also black hair. We're looking a lot better than we were before. Also, there's a sunset in the depths. I don't know what the fuck is going on there, but okay. I'm going to escape the depths now. I'm going to get my murmur and then I'm going to come back down to the depths. Actually, no, I need to get a worn cog as well. I'm going to get a worn cog, get my murmur, come back down to the depths, and then finally get auto stream. And then the build's pretty much max. We just need to get our bell after that. And I'll probably be able to get my bell just from doing the diluvian mechanism a bunch of times. All right, I can't lie. I really like the look of the purple eyes and the purple crown. It looks so good of Astral, bro. When the build's max and we got all the drips, so it's going to look so nice. I might get like a purple brilliant cape as well. But yeah, so all I need to do now is just go up to Miner's Land and get a worn cog so we can craft the armor. Kill Kaido with the auto manifestation. Get auto stream. And then the build's pretty much max. I just need to get bell. Hopefully we get corrupt cray slots. If not, I'm going to just keep on farming layer 2 runs until I get it. But yeah, I can't really be asked too much. You don't really need corrupt cray slots. It'll just be hella nice, especially with the insanity downside as well. That would be so helpful with Lose Your Mind. Okay, I don't know why it took me so long to get that worn cog. I can't lie. I got the fucking broken Gatling gun before the worn cog for some weird reason. So yeah, and I'm getting ganked. All right, interesting. Okay, why are you... Okay, uppercut. Dodged the vent. Okay, I dodged the vent, but it still fucking hit me somehow. Revenge. Into Exhausted Strike. Onslaught. Bro, you're getting cooked. You're getting cooked. You're getting cooked. You're actually getting cooked. You're actually getting cooked. Where are you running? Where are you running to? Where are you running to? Where are you running to? Come back. Parry that. Crit. Spit in his face. Dickhead. Come here. Uppercut again. Oh, you're actually fucked, bro. You're actually fucked. What's that meta? Shut up, bro. Alright, I can't lie. I'm gonna bank this broken Gatling gun just in case I ever want it on any of my future builds. Cause that shit is usually so hard to get. Like, I never get this, bro. I don't know how. I had like 20 worn cogs on a different build. And then I still didn't get the broken Gatling gun. So yeah, I'm gonna bank that real quick. And then I'm gonna go and kill Kaido. If you got auto, I might be able to actually level up. I might not even have to reroll any talents. Let's see. I should have got enough HP from that, right? Alright, yeah, no, perfect. Alright, we're power 20 now. Auto stream. Ooh, perfect. Let's go. I'm gonna burn Loose Skipper because I don't think I need any more res. Alright, auto stream. Let's see what else we get. Duelist Dance, Heavy Hull, Running Impact, Metador, Conquer Fizz. Oh, I need Conquer Fizz to get thingy. Block breaking an enemy applies an extended knockdown. Yeah, sure. I want to get that. Why the hell no? Spinning Swordsman, Berserker, Precise Swing, Song Stern. I'll get a Strong Stern. And then we get more Whispers. I'm gonna just roll 2. I don't need any monsters. I'm gonna be real. Let's see what we get. Hopefully we get Conquer Your Fears. Impairing, bro. Base cast will slay your enemy. Let's see what the other time that we get is. All right, we got a low stride, unfortunately, but it is what it is. All right, I'm gonna go down to the depths now and just do a bunch of the diluvian mechanism by myself until I get bell. Because you can bell check inside of the diluvian mechanism place now as well, which is nice. All right, guys, I can't lie. I can't really be asked to farm for bell in this prog. I've already been progressing for like 2 hours and I really want to get this video out like ASAP. But yeah, you man can remake the build if you want. It's really easy to make. I already said all the stats that you need to go. You can go silent heart if you want to. Since you're always gonna be spamming auto stream, you can spec those 40 points for overflowing dam into agility instead, just so you can get the extra 10% M1 damage that Silent Heart has when you parish it. You don't have to if you want to, but if you want to you might as well. I honestly prefer going blindside though with Silas Beam too. But yeah, if you man enjoyed this video, please remember to like and subscribe. I'm gonna try and get corrupt crystals off camera. But yeah, I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day, and yeah, peace out.